myself, never aspired to be where you are right now, the greatest ones who are in your corps, in our country, and in your group. I'm going to tell you a little bit about what it was like before I came in the Army. I was a school teacher, whether or not, before I came in active duty. Hardest thing a school teacher does is try to motivate high school students. It's almost impossible. And there's a story about a history teacher trying to motivate that class that day. Teacher asked them about quotes, and he said, "Who said, 'One person, one small step for man, one giant leap for all mankind?'" Nobody said a thing. In the back of the room, this student raised his hand, a Japanese exchange student, and said, "Neil Armstrong, July 17th, 1969. Teacher said, "That's wonderful." She said, "All right. Who said, ask how much you can do for you, ask what you can do for your country?" Silence. And again, a hand was raised. And it was a little Japanese exchange student who said, "John F. Kennedy, January 21st, 1961. Teacher looked around and said, "That's correct." And she says, "You Americans should all be ashamed of yourself. Here is an exchange student, one who's not even from our own country, doesn't even know our own culture. He knows about our history." And then from the back you hear, "Who really cares about the Japanese anyway?" The teacher's horrified. Teacher says, "Who said that? Who would dare to make a comment like that in this classroom and embarrass our guest?" In the rear you hear, "Harry Truman, May 5th, 1945. When you think about it, Harry Truman had a very interesting way of looking at life, looking at his own leadership. I'm going to talk a little bit about leadership today and about maybe being spiritual leaders. And every one of us may not be people of prayer sometimes, but every one of us are spiritual leaders. And prayer is really what is behind our soldiers and our families. And I'm sure many of you really say that it really is the prayers that make your family that got you through the last 4 years of college sometimes. I mean, my mother will tell you that she prayed me out of college, out of advanced camp in Fort Bragg. She prayed me out of jump school, and she prayed me out of the seminary. She got me through the war college also sometimes. That paper just wasn't going through. But prayer is very important. Every one of you have played and will continue to play a great role in the defense of our nation. In your own way, you truly are spiritual leaders. Powerful people that have impacted others in the past will impact soldiers for years to come in what you're doing and how you go about doing your work every day. Look, in our Army, I can think of many leaders that really have impacted me. I'm going to talk about one leader that really comes to mind right away to me. And General Bartella knows him quite well. Lieutenant General retired John Mines. J.R. Mines was the hardest man I've ever met in my life. Also a very fine man of faith that I've ever met. As I said before, he was the hardest they come. His nickname was the Viper. So after taking command of 18th Airborne Corps, he had a group of soldiers around him, and he said, "You can ask any question you want to ask me." The sergeant majors all took a deep breath, because they never knew what's going to come out of the soldier's mouth sometimes. So one soldier raised his hand and said, "Sir, what are your hobbies?" He says, "I got two hobbies." He said, "Stopping bad guys, and killing bad guys, and it's taking care of soldiers." When you think about it, those are pretty good hobbies for an infantryman. He was a real leader. He took care of every soldier that ever came upon him that he ever met. They all knew his name. And he instilled hope in every one of those young troopers. Every soldier that ever worked for him will tell you that. So one soldier I want to talk about this really hardened infantryman. If not in Iraq, we had the BUA, the Battle Update Assessment. So all the MSCs, his subordinate commanders, would brief the CG what had happened in their sectors that day. The first slides we saw were the hardest ones to look at. Numbers of engaging with the enemy insurgents, number of Americans, coalition forces, and Iraqi civilians whose lives were lost that day. And in that time, it was kind of overwhelming because it was the surge was on. In one of my meetings with the CG, he asked me if it was possible to honor a foreign hero every day, to put a face on just one of those numbers that we talked about. So we did that. Every night we pause to tell the story of one of those fallen heroes. Many families that students may have been. Each night, the CG is hardened ranger infantryman would command paratroopers of the war on a battalion, brigade, and corps and division level. Would pause while we pray for that hero, for that family. That was true leadership. He was a true Army leader, but above all, he led with his head and also with his heart. Remember the spirit of the soldier. We hear lots about leadership. People have discussed it for years. I mean, we can see tomes and volumes about it. We think that people have given us famous quotes. But spiritual leadership, leadership in faith, certainly has a very different view of the role of leaders. Maybe it's stopping bad guys, or better, maybe changing the views of bad guys. And I know it's taking care of peoples. If we look at Christian scripture, we see the people chosen by Jesus to lead the fledgling church. They were far from perfect. Not totally upstanding citizens, fishermen, tax collectors, and those who would betray him. It looked like those who aspire for our Army Corps values. No denomination really has given the world some interesting leaders in the past century. John the 23rd, the man who fought to be an interim pope, the church waited for Giovanni Montini to mature. John turned the church upside down and called him Vatican II. And then Paul the VI, often known as Giovanni Montini, was the one who had closed that council, all the changes, and led the many changes that brought about by that gust fire that met in Rome in the mid-1960s. John Paul II, the impact of the world, would be felt for decades to come. Both these men of the church had different styles, but a common purpose. Purpose of leading the faithful in ways of spiritual growth. Everyone was a character, and they had character, and they instilled character in their leadership style. Religious communities in the past are full of them. Mahatma Gandhi, Teresa of Calcutta, Dietrich Bonhoeffer, Maximilian Kolbe, all gave their lives to leading other people. Every one of those people had character, and they instilled character that was unmistakable of giving of themselves. General John Wickham, the former chief of staff of the Army, wrote, "The character is a habit, a daily choice of being right and wrong. Character makes us who we are. It defines our spirituality, it defines who we are, defines us as moral creatures. Character really is developed in the calm times of our own lives. Character helps us to withstand the rigors of our own combats, our own inner battles, strengthens our values, makes us better individuals, makes our inner selves embodied to other people. It's who we are. It's not developed, that as George Patton wrote, grows out of a steady application of moral values, ethical behavior in our lives." Think for a moment of the people that have done exactly that. People that have tested in the crucible of life have shown moral courage, have shown character, have shown